Let's talk about the question word where, which is doko in this lesson. When you want to ask a question, where is it? You can simply say doko desu ka? Doko desu ka? For instance, if you want to ask where is the restroom, in Japanese, you phrase it as for the restroom, where is it? And go like this. トイレはどこですか? トイレはどこですか? Where is the restroom? However, when you want to ask a question like where do you, where will you, or where did you, then you cannot use desu ka because you are going to have a verb in your question. How to use the question word doko with a verb in your questions? That's what we are going to learn in this lesson. When you ask where and have a verb in your question, these two particles are going to be very crucial. Particle de and particle ni. Each one has a few different functions in Japanese, but today we are going to deal with them as a place of action marker and destination marker. Now, what you need to figure out is this. Do you need to ask doko de or doko ni in your question? The difference between these two is this. When you are asking doko de, you are asking where at. On the other hand, when you are asking doko ni, you are asking where to. It's fundamentally important that you pick the right one depending on the verb that you're using in your question. Okay, let me explain more by using sample questions. The first sample question is this. Where do you buy? And the second question is this. Where do you go? Now, pay attention to the verb in each question. The first one has buy, and the second one has go, right? And even though the question word where is used in the same manner in these two sentences in English, in Japanese, we use them differently because these two are asking for different kinds of information. One is asking where at, and the other one is asking where to. Can you tell which one is which? Right. In the first sentence, because of the verb buy, the question is asking where at. In the second sentence, because of the verb go, it's asking where to. So in Japanese, for the first one, we have to ask doko de. And for the second one, we have to ask doko ni. I hope now you understand what I was talking about earlier. You have to pick the right version of doko depending on the verb that you have in your question. And from here, to complete the question, you just add the verb. For the first one, you say buy in Japanese, which is 買います. And don't forget to add the question particle ka. For the second one, you say go, which is 行きます with the ka at the end. That's it. Now they are complete. Where do you buy in Japanese is どこで買いますか? どこで買いますか? And where do you go is どこに行きますか? どこに行きますか? Very good. And of course, since the must form of Japanese verbs can also indicate future tense, depending on the context, these two questions can also mean where will you buy and where will you go, if the sentence has the future time expressions such as tomorrow, this coming weekend, next month, or next year. If you want to change these questions into the past tense, then now you need to change the verb into the past form, like this. So if you want to ask, where did you buy? You have to say, どこで買いましたか?どこで買いましたか? And then, where did you go is going to be, どこに行きましたか?どこに行きましたか? Now, if you want to expand the first question like this, where did you buy lunch? Do you know how to do it? Right. You simply need to add the new unit to the sentence, which is lunch, and mark it with the particle o. That's it.So, where did you buy lunch in Japanese is どこで昼ごはんを買いましたか?どこで昼ごはんを買いましたか? And of course, if you want, you can switch these two units. They don't have to be in this order. It's all up to you. For the second question, if you want to expand it this way,Where did you go yesterday? Now you need to add the new unit to the sentence, which is the time expression yesterday. Yesterday is 昨日 in Japanese, so it's going to be like this. 昨日どこに行きましたか?昨日どこに行きましたか? And again, you can switch these two if you want.I hope now you understand and feel confident as to how to use the question word doko with the right particle when you have a verb in your question. Again, the most crucial part is to figure out if you need to use doko de or doko ni in your sentence. Let's review it one more time. When you ask doko de, you are asking where at.When you ask どこに, you are asking where to. Very good. In the next lesson, let's see how much you can use どこ in your questions by trying some translation exercises together. ではまた次のレッスンで会いましょう。